in 2012 coverage now, and tonight we are taking a look at the Marina City Council. Five candidates are running for a chance to be one of two elected council members. Hot button issues include four-door development, jobs, and city finances. Action News reporter Jacqueline Mazur interviewed the candidates and has our story tonight.
Strong note of his character and dedication that...
Incumbent Jim Ford says he wants four-door development plans to come to fruition to help bring well-paying jobs to Marina for his children and everyone else's.
I'm fearful that if we don't develop four-door, then those opportunities are not available to them because they can't afford to live here, they can't afford to buy a house because the jobs are not here to allow them to do that.
Candidate Larry Starkey is eager to get the ball rolling when it comes to development in Marina as well. He says he's tired of stalled projects.
So what I would like to see is Marina to become more friendly in bringing businesses into the city, but more specifically, a primary example for me is Marina Heights.
The four-door reuse authority has two projects on hold. Marina Heights, a residential project that will be developed on approximately 250 acres. And the Dunes on Monterey Bay, a mixed-use project with residential, retail, and business on roughly 420 acres. Cypress Knolls, the senior residential project, is also on hold. So is Marina Station, an additional housing development.
If I'm reelected, what I'd like to see happen is that various projects that are fully entitled get going. Cypress Knolls, Marina Heights, Marina Station, the economy starting to turn around.
Incumbent Frank O'Connell denies no growth. He says he's supported and endorsed by both the labor union and the building and trade union.
So thank you all.
And development is a hot button issue for candidate Darlena Ridler, too. She spent the past 34 years working as a financial manager for the federal government. She's eager to bring her financial expertise to the city in an effort to get these community projects funded.
Oh, I am desperate to see Cypress Knolls developed. We've been working on it since in the 1990s we started. It was transferred as property to the city of Marina. We've had lots of design charrettes over the years. The community has participated in it in a huge way.
And amidst all the cries for development throughout Marina, candidate Gail Morton, an attorney in Monterey, is hoping to preserve what she calls the outdoor splendor and recreational opportunities the city of Marina has in its possession. All this development isn't a sustainable resource, she says.
We've overlooked this for the last two decades. We instead have focused on more houses. We have all of this plastic-wrapped construction that's not going to happen for the next 20 years. We need an alternative, sustainable source of revenue to balance our budget.
And balancing the city's budget, as well as determining how best to utilize Fort Ord, are items these candidates agree are of supreme importance to the city of Marina. Each candidate, in turn, hoping for the chance to decide how best to move forward. In Marina, Jacqueline Mazur, KSBW, Action News 8.